Because, well, you know, God is taking care of it. It must be fine. God will never leave you nor forsake you. God will never, never leave you or forsake you.
All right.
So don't take this wrong. Don't take this message wrong. But we can find ourselves in uncertainty and comfortable at the same time. We need to make our mindsets know comfort in uncertainty.
All right.
Because the devil wants nothing more than for us to be comfortable in the wilderness.
All right.
As long as the children of Israel were in the wilderness, they were not affected.
All right.
As long as the children of Israel were walking in the wilderness, they were growing their church. As long as the children of Israel were walking in the wilderness, they were spreading the gospel. As long as we're walking in what we find comfortable instead of what we find to be the will of God, we're not going to grow on ourselves or as a church.
All right.
We need to take the comfort and we need to throw it out.
All right.
The comfort that we find in uncertainty. We need to change our mindset. We need to change our hearts.
Right.
And we need to find no comfort in everything that we do.
All right.
If you're not uncomfortable somewhere, at some point in your life, look at what you're going through. Look at what you're in.
All right.
God's still taking care of every need.
Amen.
God's still walking you through. God's still taking care of you. But are you really in the promise?
All right.
Are you really in what God wants you to be in?
Yeah.
Are you really in the strength that God wants you to have? Are you really walking in the power of His might? God has given us opportunity after opportunity. My pastor calls them kingdom appointments.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes,
sir. I've had multiple of these where God has given me an opportunity to step out and to step into the things of God, and I have to be ready in my mind.
Right.
I've noticed when I'm comfortable in uncertainty, and I'm comfortable in the things that I shouldn't be comfortable in, I miss those appointments. Because God's taking care of my needs, why do I have to talk to them?
All right.
But when I'm in the promise, it's too good for me to keep my mouth shut. So when I'm in the promises of God, I have to tell them about Jesus. When I'm in the likeness and the boldness of God, I have to tell them. I have to. Somebody asked me what I believe. I can't say, well, I can't talk to you about that right now. I'm at work. That doesn't work for me. I tell them.
Praise
my
God.
Bosses are all very, very softly patted. And they don't like it when I start talking about Jesus. Because it kind of goes against someone they believe.
All right.
Sorry, but it does.
Right.
And they don't like it.
Yeah.
But does it stop me? No.
Oh.
Why? Because God has been too good for me for someone else's uncertainty to be my meditation.
Right. Right.
Don't let someone else's uncertainty limit you in what you can do for God. Don't let someone else's discomfort, well, you can't talk about that here. Don't let that limit what God can do in your life. You got to be willing to open your mouth, willing to take the step, willing to go forward in what God has given you. You have to be willing to open your mouth for the things of God. You can't be comfortable in uncertainty.
All right.
Our mindsets need to change. I found in Romans chapter 13, verse 13, let us walk honestly in the day, not in rioting and drunkenness, not in chambering and wantonness, not in strife and envy, but put ye on the Lord Jesus Christ, and make not provision for the flesh to fulfill the lust thereof. One of the last things Bishop Eastman said to me was to love the impossible people. That was one. The next thing he said was never do anything anywhere you go that when you go back, you can't hold your head high.
All right.
Everywhere you go, you hold your head high.
All right.
And you do what's right by God.
All right.
Because if you do what's in the Word of God, everywhere you go, you never have to worry about going back someplace.
All right.
How many of us have that place we don't want to go back to because we're embarrassed how we act?
All right.
It happens.
Yeah.
But when we're walking in God, walk honestly.
Yeah.
As in the day. Not in riotousness and drunkenness, not in chambering and wantonness, not in strife and envy, but this next verse. But put ye on the Lord Jesus Christ.
Right.
And make not provision for the flesh.
Right.
Make not provision for the flesh. That's what the children of Israel were doing. They took the provision God has given them and they called that enough. We can find ourselves in that and we can believe that's enough. We have provision. God's taking care of our needs. Everything's going to be fine. That's enough. It's not. It's not enough.
All right.
I don't know if I can say that enough. It is not enough to have provision. The land flowed with milk and honey. The promise flowed with milk and honey. And they were settling for manna.
Yes, Lord.
The promise had everything they needed. They were settling for the same thing every day. The promised land had every grace that they needed at the time, and they settled for manna and their clothes not wearing out. If they would have took the promise, their life would have been a whole lot better.
All right.
This verse, after it says, make not provision for the flesh. It says to fulfill the lust thereof. You're making provisions for your own flesh and not the things of God. You're fulfilling the lust of the flesh. You're fulfilling the very thing that God doesn't want you to fulfill. Well, it's certainly about the, you know, who wins in the fight of good and evil.
Yeah.
Whatever one you feed the most.
All right.
Who wins in this fight between us and God? Whatever one we feed the most.
All right.
We want a life in the spiritual life, the life filled with Holy Ghost and that power in our life. What one are we going to feed? Are we fulfilling the lust thereof in the flesh?
All right.
Are we believing, walking, and we putting on the Lord, Jesus Christ? It's our call. It doesn't say that we wake up and Jesus tells us that. He told us here to walk honestly as in the day. Those walk honestly and put on the Lord Jesus Christ. It shouldn't be a question of what we do. Every day, put on the Lord Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Put on the whole armor of God.
Amen.
So how do you stand with the whole armor of God?
Right.
We could all stand.
Praise God.
I found in this journey the children of Israel were on. Was filled with uncertainty, filled with doubt, filled with false gods, filled with ugly marked people.
Oh, God.
Sound a lot like our lives today.
Yeah.
But what are we doing to protect ourselves from?
Yes.
But look ye on the Lord Jesus Christ. This place is filled with unsurety and question. It was so filled with all of these things that people believed it and missed the promise. The people you rub shoulders with rub off on you. The people you walk around with and you listen to rub off on you.
All right.
Put pillars in your life that matter. You have one of the greatest pastors you could ever have.
That's right.
Lean on him.
Yes, sir.
Your youth leader is strong. Lean on him.
Yes, sir.
Your elders are strong. Lean on him. They know the truth.
Yeah.
They know the word of God. And they know how to make it. There's no uncertainty. They're standing strong in this city that is filled with people that want to do nothing but tear down Jesus. We want to make a difference in this world. We need to put on Jesus. We need to put on His glory. We need to get rid of the provision of the flesh. We need to get rid of the mindset that I'm comfortable because God's still taking care of me. It's not enough. We have to have the will of God in our lives. We have to have the grace of God in our lives.
Jesus.
You haven't been baptized, filled with the Holy Ghost. You don't know what I'm talking about when I'm talking about the promise. These altars are open.
Praise God.
And God's here to answer your questions. Your pastor's here to answer your questions.
Amen.
Oh, hallelujah, Jesus.